Yeah, and so I, then I decided it was, you know, I sort of had come to the end of one 5-year plan. I was thinking about what to do next, and I had always in the back of my mind assumed that I would move back to Nigeria. It was home. My mother was here, and then my mother unfortunately passed away.
Sorry about that.
But before she died, she and I had sort of discussed my coming, and so I came home because I told her that I would.
Yeah.
And also because I think, you know, it's one thing to sit and I think, look, people should live wherever they want and everybody should choose the struggle that makes sense for them. You know, and I'm not one of those people, like, if you're not in Nigeria, like, you don't believe, but I also feel like if you sit somewhere else and you talk about the problems, that's one thing, but also it is something to come and attempt to be a part of the solution and contribute in your own way. And so I came home to see, right, how I could contribute. And the first couple of years, you know, I bounced around a little bit because I also wasn't willing to settle, right? I wanted to find a role that made sense to me, that was fulfilling, that I thought I could add to. You spend a lot of time at work, especially like in your early 30s, and I wanted to work somewhere where I wanted to be. And then, you know, as luck will have it, a friend of mine was working at an agency, it was ZK Advertising then, and they didn't have a strategist, and they were doing a pitch, they were pitching FCMB, I remember. And so I just, you know, he said, will you come and help us with this pitch? And I was sort of transitioning from a job at Hi TV. So I'm sure I have a little bit of time. And then after the pitch, they offered me a job. Right? They were like, you know, we don't have a strategist. You seem great. So I joined ZK as their director of strategy. And I was running a strategy for Celtel across Africa. And then, you know, helping build the agency. The agency was also quite new. And, you know, sort of 10, let's, so that was 2007, 2011, we lost the Celtel account, which is our biggest account. And we lost like 70% of our income in one day. It was like the hardest day of my life. I went home and I just cried, right? And then my then boss said to me, you know, let's do this, right? And I will always say that I was never planning to start a business. I'm as anyone in my family will tell you, Nana does not like stress. Then I'm least likely to like disturb herself, right? But Calico was like, you know, we talk all the time about what we would do if it was our agency. Here's our chance to do it, right? Do this thing with me. And so the MD, myself, and the person who was then our director of ops, right, decided we were going to start our own agency. And that's we started the Yellowbrick Road in 2010. We'd signed the official paperwork, but in 2011, right, the agency was live. And yeah, and then we just started, and you know, and it's interesting, right, because ZK had been a really kind of a big agency, because Celtel at the time was the biggest accounts in Nigeria, and we went from being the agency with the biggest account to the agency with no accounts in like a day, and that kind of a fall is heartbreaking, and to be honest, it's humiliating, right? Even though we didn't lose the And even though we didn't lose the account through anything that we did, there was a global realignment, but it's like, but you know, right? Like you're in an industry, these people were not up here now.
Yeah.
Right.
Not here.
If you're opening a door, we'll come and pitch to help you advertise. And the early years were really tough. I won't lie. Like, you know, it was really tough. And I'm so grateful for my business partners, because I cannot imagine having done that alone. Having a, you know, two other people who were in this with you, who were had a shared vision, and who were just really ready to sit down and do the work. And over the last 10 years, we've built an institution that I'm really proud of, right? And I'm really proud of what we've done with YBR. But also, I've been doing this work now for 20-something years, right? And so last year, I think, you know, lockdown was really useful in some ways, because it forced me, right? It narrowed my life. And I spent a lot of my time working, because also now the world is in crisis. You've got to keep this business afloat. You have to make sure that you're able to pay salaries, right? And I realized that I wasn't as passionate about the work as I used to be. And I thought that was a disservice to myself, but also to the agency, right? And I think since about 2015, I had also really begun to think about succession planning because I really wanted YBR to continue after me. And I recognized that you have to be intentional, right? You have to be intentional. You have to signal to the organization that this chair will become available. So I used to talk all the time, right?
Yeah.
About when I go, not because I was planning to leave imminently, but I wanted people to understand that wasn't going to be one of those people who was going to die in my
life,
chair, right?
Yeah.
I was like, this was a lifetime appointment. And then in Q4 of last year, I hired my replacement, which is not a common thing in Nigeria.
Yeah.
As people were like, are you mad? What do you mean you're leaving your business? After you spent all this time building, do not just go. But, you know, I retained my ownership. But I said, look, one, the agency needs new blood, new ideas, energy, right? I started this at 36. I'm now 48. It's not the same thing.